We always change up our speeches, don't we, huh? You know, a lot of politicians, they go around and they say the exact same speech for months. Not a word change. It doesn't, even if history is changing in front of their very eyes, it's that same speech over and over again. And then they wonder why nobody listens. With me, there's always a risk, especially when I go off these suckers, right? Right?
That is definitely true. There is always a risk, because when Trump goes off script, he says painfully stupid things like this.
Now, all I know about magnets is this. Give me a glass of water. Let me drop it on the magnets. That's the end of the magnets.
No, it isn't. It just isn't.
Okay. Hold on. I got to give more context, because I'm sure the audience is like, why are we talking about magnets? What is this about? So if you're confused about what's going on here, so was he. So basically, this is what happened. On Friday, Trump was speaking at his rally in Iowa, where he complained about electric catapults and magnetic elevator systems on US aircraft carriers, because obviously. And you know, it's something that everyone can relate to. It's something that most Americans are concerned about. So he decided to like riff on that issue. And so he said he talked to one of these catapulters about how much worse the electrical versions were compared to old steam ones. And then in this long nonsensical diatribe and rant, he decided to conflate electrical circuits with magnetism. And so let's watch some more context about giving you an idea of what he was discussing here, and then we'll discuss.
I could tell you about aircraft carriers where they use electric catapults. They couldn't go to the steam, which works better for about 1/100th the price, you know, the electric catapult, you know that story. And when the steam got hit with a wave, which we do a lot, sir, those waves are bigger than these ships. He said, when the steam got hit with a wave, sir, it didn't have any impact. In fact, it was nice. We loved it. When the electric gets hit with a little piece of water like this, you could drop it with the glass. That's the end of that system. So a little complicated, but it was pretty simple, actually. They had an almost $1 billion cost overrun on the magnetic elevators. Think of it, magnets. Now, all I know about magnets is this. Give me a glass of water. Let me drop it on the magnets. That's the end of the magnets. Why didn't they use John Deere? Why didn't they bring in the John Deere people? Do you like John Deere? I like John Deere, but with the hydraulic, right?
I really think that he was just trying to appeal to like John Deere workers. And he did it in this weird roundabout way by discussing something that he doesn't really know too much about. So he's presumably talking about the electromagnetic aircraft launch system, a type of catapult system that was developed for the United States Navy. But his comments about magnets were so wrong that Community Notes on X, formerly known as Twitter, corrected him. And so here's what that looked like. And in case it isn't abundantly clear, magnets do in fact work underwater and are not affected by water. Magnetic fields are not the same as electrical circuits. Cenk.
Yeah. Okay, so it's easy to say, haha, he's an idiot, but there's a giant upside in all this for Trump. There's actually two upsides. One is, so okay, first of all, on him saying that the regular politicians are fake and phonies.
True.
Man, that resonates. So when he says that, everybody in Washington can catch feelings, the Democrats can tut tut tut, but we're talking about trying to win over general election voters, the average American. The average American thinks that the politicians are totally fake, totally phonies, read the stupid prompter, same old speeches every time. He's never been more right. So that's a giant win for him. Then there's actually three layers of the win, because I'll add in another layer, which is when he says dumbass things, he gets more press. Because how could you not do a story about how don't you drop a magnet in the water gun? Well, it's so wrong that you have to do a story, and it's also hilarious. And you're like, why did you make up such an insane thing? Remember when he made up about how the noise from the windmills kills the whales underneath the water? Like, it's not even close to true, but he'll make up these outrageous things that get him more and more press. Meanwhile, Biden's still taking a nap, still in the bunker, right? Just forever and ever and ever. Now, doesn't know how to get press, does the kind of speeches that Trump is referring to. So
he's getting those weapons to Israel, though.
Yeah. Now, the third significant win for Trump on things like this, when he goes off script, it gives the feeling of authenticity. And that feeling is correct. That is the authentic Donald Trump. The authentic Donald Trump barely pays attention to what anybody is saying. Somebody says something about magnet, he misunderstood it. He comes out and he goes, oh, can you believe it? $1 million, drop a magnet, gun. Right, that's the real Donald Trump. He's like kind of a clown that's kind of funny, but an idiot, right? But there's a last link of that chain that isn't true, but a lot of people think is. When he's that authentic, it gives you a feeling that he's being honest. Because authenticity and honesty are oftentimes connected. But in Donald Trump's case, they're not at all connected. He's authentic, but completely dishonest. And so as a matter of theatrics and as a matter of politics, he is on a more correct track. Even if you say the most outlandishly stupid things, if you say them in a way that is authentic, even if they're wildly dishonest, people will think you're honest, more honest than a standard politician who's reading off a prompter. So overall, we can all laugh, but it's relatively well played, and that's why he's doing as well as he is.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.